In this section, we're going to be covering the node tool. So I've been using the pen tool a lot, and we just used it on that course that I just did. But let's say that you didn't do too well if you were going to try it. Well, you can use the node tool to clean this up. So let's just learn by doing. So I'm going to click on the node tool. The shortcut is A. So I've clicked on it, and now I'm going to zoom in to this first one here. And I'm going to try and clean this up. First of all, I can select the item like I've done there, and I can see all the nodes. If we look at the context toolbar, we have many options, but some of them are grayed out. So if I go ahead and just select one of the nodes, you see some of the options appear. So it's based on what you've selected, it will give you different options. So for the basics, you can click on a node and you can move it around like this. You can also click the path here and click and drag it like this. And I'll just press Command Z to go back, and you can perform other actions. But for now, let's just try and tidy it up so it matches the gray line in the background. Let's go ahead and click on the first node and place it where we think it should be. Okay, excellent. And we'll just keep going through clicking the nodes, and these are all sharp nodes as you can see, and just clicking them so they all line up. Okay, that was easy enough. Let's go to this next one. It looks all over the place. So I'm going to select it, and I can see the first node is the smooth node, so I'm happy with that. I'll just line that up properly. And the next one, this one really should be smooth. So in order for us to turn it into a smooth node, we can either go up to Convert Options in the context toolbar and choose the middle one here, which is smooth. Click on that. There is another way to do it, and that is if I press Command Z, and that is when we hover over the node, we can simply hold down Control and click. And that's turned it into a smooth node again. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to drag it up here, grab the handle and twist it around. So these smooth nodes have handles and you can use the node tool to play around with them. So the next one just looks slightly out of place. So I'm just going to drag it down to about here. And I'm just going to drag this handle inwards and across like this until it perfectly lines up. So this next one should be completely flat. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go up to the snapping options up here. I'm going to click on that. I'm going to go back to the node and I'm going to drag it down, and you see it's snapping to the node on the left. Okay, that's great. So this one looks like it should be completely flat. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to drag this node up here. And in fact, I don't need snapping on right now because it seems to be snapping to something over there. So I'm just going to place it around here. And one of the ways you could do it is this. You can hold down Option. You can hover over this handle and click once on that. And you can go over to there, hold Option and click. So that's Alt key, by the way, as well for Windows. Another way you could do that is if I press Command Z to go back. When you hover over the path here, you can hold down Option and you can see a flat line icon appears, and I could just click once and then it just turns into a flat one. And it's got sharp nodes both sides. So the next one is me just dragging it down, and this seems like it went straight into place, so I'm happy with that. And lastly, I know that this needs to be completely flat, so I'm going to need to turn on that snapping again and just drag it down, and there we go. That's all perfectly lined up and I'm quite happy with the result. So the next one is a circle. I'll just turn snapping off for a second. One of the things I could do is, first of all, just try and get all of these points where I think they should be. So I'll drag that to here and this one to here and this one over here. I will turn on snapping at this point because I want all of these nodes to line up because there's only four of them. So I'm going to click on this one, I'm going to drag it to about here, and I know that lines up with this, and I'll do the same with this bottom one here. Okay, that's lined up nicely. So I know I need to turn this into a smooth node, but I can always just drag this handle down. And when it gets to a certain point, it just turns into a smooth node, you see. And with this one here, I will just select this and I'll go up to Convert and I'll click on Smooth. So it looks like I need to drag this handle out a little bit more. So I'm going to drag that, but I don't want it to affect everything else. So I'm just going to press Command Z. I'm going to hold down Shift and I'm going to click, and it's going to stay perfectly vertical. So I can just drag down there, and I'll do the same thing with this side as well. Hold Shift, click and drag. And I'll do the same thing for this side as well, but this time I'll just use that shortcut and press Control and click. And that's turned it into a smooth node. Again, I can hold down Shift, click and drag up here. If I thought that these were equal both sides, I could just hold down Control, click and drag, and it will bring it out both sides. But you know what? In this scenario, I'm not going to do that. I could hold shift just to double check. No, it's not quite there. So what I'll do is press Command Z to go back, and I'll just hold down shift, click, and just drag down. So that seems to be perfectly lined up. Okay, so now we're going to try and line up this one, and this is all over the place. So we'll start from the beginning, and this one is smooth node, and I don't want that. So I could just hold down Option and click once, and it's turned it into a sharp node. And yeah, that's about right there. In fact, I could turn off snapping at this point because I can see it's slightly over. So I can select both of those and bring them up slightly, click off, and then continue along. So this one looks like it's kind of almost in the right place, but it seems like it's missing one. So what we can do with the node tool, we can add them. So just hovering over this path, I could just click once here and it's added a node. And obviously it's a smooth node because either side was smooth. And I actually want this to be a sharp one. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to hold down Option and click and drag that in like this. And for this one up here, I'll just click and drag it up to see whether it matches. Okay, it's matching pretty well. I think with this one, I need to drag it out slightly. And if I don't want it to move around when I'm dragging it, I can just hold down Shift. There we go. For this one, it just seems like I have to drag it in there. And sometimes it's good to just try and drag all of these nodes into the place where you think they're going to be, if you are tracing something that is, and then make the changes that you need to. So like this, I know that that should be a sharp one, so I'm going to hold down Option, click once. So going back to this one to try and fix it, I'll just drag this out slightly, click on that node again, drag it out slightly, there we go, something like that. And this needs to be played around with a little bit, so I'll just click on that node and bring that up. And this one could probably go down a little bit. So that's done. So I need to know that this is completely in line. So what I'm going to do is just turn on snapping again. This one here, align to nodes of selected curves. So I'll select that and you can see it's snapping to it. So over here, I can just grab this one, place it in the corner, and you can see it's snapping to this one over here. And actually it hasn't finished. I have to continue drawing along. So what I can either do is press on the pen tool again, as it's selected, and just click once on there and it's completed. Or I can press Command Z to go back, or I can simply head on up to the context toolbar, and under the action, you can see one here, it says close curve. I could just click on that and it's closed it for me. So this one here, I'll just select that. You can see it has many nodes on it. There's too many, I think. So there is this option, and I don't use it that often, but it's called smooth curve. So if I just click it once, you can see there's less smooth nodes on there now. I click it again, there's even less. And the more you click it, it kind of tries to work out what's the best way to make it smooth and have less nodes. It doesn't always work, but it seems to be working pretty well.